हेलो बच्चों, कैसे हो? आपका स्वागत है त्रिपाण स्टडी सेंटर में। आज जो आपके समक्ष टॉपिक प्रस्तुत हुआ है, कई मायने में काफ़ी महत्वपूर्ण है हर एक एग्जाम व्यू से, ठीक है। इसमें हम हर एक बात पे विस्तार पर चर्चा करेंगे और वो सारे जो है पहलू पर विचार करेंगे जो अब तक अछूता था। तो चलिए देखते हैं हमारा आज टॉपिक क्या है। अ डिज़ायर टू बी चेंज सोशल रिलीजियस एंड अवेकनिंग, दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक हियर। अ डिज़ायर टू बी चेंज, व्हाट यू मीन डिज़ायर टू द चेंज हियर? What do you think could be a reason that led to the awakening of the peoples against discrimination and inequality? There is a most important question here. What do you think could be a reason that led to the awakening of the peoples against discrimination and inequality? Reformers like Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar and Swami Dayanand Saraswati and Jyotibai Phule, Asad Ahmad Khan and Pandita Ramabai understood that ignorance and the backwardness in the society was responsible for the hindering. It's a progress and development. And this realization was reinforced when they come in contact with the Europeans and found that life was very different in the other part of the world. You know that there is a most important thing here. There is the Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, Swami Dayanand Saraswati, Jyotibai Phule, Ahmad Khan and Pandita Ramabai. There is a more understood here. There are development and progressive. This realization as a reinforced began to the come contact with the European and found that life was very different in other part of the world. When the British missionary started to spreading Christianity, there is a satirized and questioned many of our social and religious practice here. Then many of there is an idea were accepted by our reformers. The desire for reform their society was so strong that these reformers was now ready to the face a challenges as well as resistance from the orthodox Indians. And they start to several movement to bearing out desirable changes in the society. That is important. This was made possible to the inheritance of people like Swami Dayanand Saraswati and Raja Ram Mohan Roy. They study their religious scripture and realize there is a prevalent religious and social practice. According to them, society should be based on the concept of liberty and equality both for a man and woman, and this was possible. This were made possible by the inheritance people like Swami Dayanand Saraswati and Raja Ram Mohan Roy. They study the religious scripture and realize there is a prevalent religious and social practice. According to them, society should be based on the concept of liberty and equality, both for man and woman, and this was possible only by the spread of modern and scientific education, especially among the women. This movement came to be called social religious movement because the reformers left that no change is possible in a society without reforming their religion. We will read up further to know why the education and privileges were to the able to buy only the upper class in society. That is important. The next year, the caste system. The caste system of 19th century, there is the most important effect here. See, in the same time, Indian society had a caste system which was originally occupations based. There is a caste system. Occupational base. And over a period of time, interruptions of the religious text by their upper caste and lack of access to be religious scripture. By the lower caste, is led to be servile, supervisional, privatist and the name of religious. And this also result in the power began to the concentrated in the upper caste and exploitations of lower caste. That is important.
हिंदू सोसाइटी वॉज बेस्ड ऑन अ बर्न सिस्टम. द हिंदू सोसाइटी बेस्ड ऑन अ बर्न सिस्टम दैट इज अ बर्न हेयर ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य एंड शूद्र. देर इज अ हिंदू सोसाइटी देर इज अ बिलीव हेयर फॉर बर्न. देर अ ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य एंड शूद्र. अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस सिस्टम पीपल वेर डिवाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर ऑक्यूपेशन. द पीपल हु वेर एंगेज अ प्रेइंग एंड वर्शिपिंग द गॉड्स वेर कैटेगराइज इन अ ब्राह्मण्स. यू नो दैट द पीपल हु वेर एंगेज इन द प्रेइंग एंड वर्शिपिंग द गॉड वेर इज अ कैटेगरी ऑफ देयर ब्राह्मण्स. एंड दोज हु वेर एंगेज इन अ वॉर वेर इज कॉल्ड एज क्षत्रिय. द वर्ड इज ऑनली रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एज क्षत्रिस हियर. And those who occupation was agriculture and trading were known as the Vaishya. And those who used to be serve the upper three wands were known as the Chudra. You know that Brahman is a prayer and worshipping. Kshatriya is only there participate in a war. And there is a Vaishya is the agriculture and trading. There is a work for the Vaishya. And Chudra here, there are three upper wands. There is a gift to the serve. There is a Chudra. And this caste system, which was purely based on occupation, had become a heredity. A person born in the particular caste could not be changed his caste, even though their mind have changed their work. And this created inequality in a society. It also lead to explorations of lower castes. Therefore, a caste system has become a major hindrance in the development of healthy, democratic, and progressive society. The caste system had become a major hindrance in the development of healthy, democratic, and progressive society. The many social religious reformer and organization stepped forward to the fight against the social practice. Organizations such as a Brahmo Samaj, Brahma Samaj and Aryan Samaj and Prathana Samaj, Rama Krishna Mission and Reform like Jyotibai Phule and Pandit Ramabai and Sri Narayan Guru, Priyaj Vivekanand and Mahatma Gandhi and many others strongly protest against this rigidity. There's a rigidity, there's a protest is a main important person and most reformer consider to the prevalent caste practice there is against the original spirit of the Vedas and other scripture. This consider there is caste system is a irrigation and unscientific here. They felt it was against the basic rules of humanity. The entering and the relentless effort of a social reformer helped to people to become a more tolerant toward the each other. The next year, the prevalent religious practice here. The prevalent religious practice. Most of the social practice were done in the name of religion. In a social reform had no meaning without a religious reform. Our reformers were deeply rooted in India traditional and philosophy and had a sound knowledge of the scripture. They were able to blend positive Indian value with the Western idea and the principle of democracy and equality. On the basis of the understanding, they challenged there is a rigidity and supervisions as a practice in the religions. They cite their scripture to be so that the practice is prevalent during the 19th century and find no sanction in them. The resistance and the religiosity among them questioned the popular religious which was full of the superstitions and they exploited by the corrupt priest. That is important. The reformers want the society to accept the rational and scientific approach. Rational and scientific approach here. And they also believed in a principle of human dignity and social equality of all women and men. The next year, the educational scenarios. The educational scenarios is important here. In the 19th century, many children, especially girls, were not sent to school on this period of time. Education was imparted in the traditional pathshala, madrasa, and muskius and gurukul. There is this question here imparted to traditional here. Pathshala, madrasa, muskius, and gurukul. Religious question was imparted to along with their subject like Sanskrit, grammar, arithmetics, religious, and philosophy. There is a most important subject on this period of time. Science and technology had no place in the curriculum. The many superstitions is a belief resided in the society. In the contained community, girls were not allowed to be educated on this period of time. It was thought that educated women would be soon become a vidham after marriage. But in the latest, lack of education and awareness was the root causes of social and religious backwardness among the Indians. So it was important to promote a modern education. Also, so as a religious reformer, whether the Hindu, Muslim, Sikh and Parsis aimed to be spread the modern education. They believed that education was the most effective tool to be awakened and modernize our society. Thank you.